Hi there, welcome back to my channel. Today we are not working on the 308. No, we're not talking about the 308. No, not today. No. As we know, I'm a big Ferrari fan. Ferrari is the thing in my life. And ever since I was a little kid, one of the first things I wanted was a Ferrari. So everything I did from then was to reach the point where I have my own Ferrari. Well, we know what happened. I got my Ferrari. It broke down, it was expensive, so now we're flogging about my repairs. And to be honest, it was one of the most amazing things I did because I like it. But now the car is at the painter, I don't know what to do. So I asked my friends, have you any idea what can I do while my car is away? So one of the guys suggested, why don't you make videos about Ferraris, reviews, take them for a drive, tell people what you think about it, etc. And you know the best part is, he offered me to take his Ferrari for my first review. So, I guess you've seen it, yes? Behind me, you see the Ferrari 599 GTB Fiorano. Amazing piece of machinery. And it's mine, all day. So, let's get in. First feeling I got, it's a scary feeling. A feeling like you have to take this car, you have to behave respectful. Yeah? It can kill you any second. There's a lot of power in it, and I'm driving very slow right now. Oh, I got some speed bumps that scare me even more than the car. But it's a scary feeling, like you know when you put your hands on the steering wheel that this thing is mighty. I think it's a good. It's good to have this feeling. Simply, oh, the bumps, man. 999. No, I think it's a good feeling because simply it forces you to have respect for this car. Take it slow. Don't push it too hard. Get to know each other before you do something wild. Just like a woman. And now I understand why we often say she and her when we talk about these cars. You have to treat her like a woman. With respect. Haha. But at the same time, it gives you excitement. I don't know, how do you call it? My heart is pounding. Oh. Fantastic little machine this is. Well, little. Wow. Anyway, it is a big car. I told you that. But to be honest, when I'm sitting here, it doesn't feel big at all. No, it's comfortable. There's a lot of room for me. I think I think this will make me smile every time I will get in this car. Be careful with the traffic. like she's screaming at you. Push the pedal, push the pedal. Normal people would start reading the instruction manual. This car has two manuals, the owner's manual and the user's manual. Now the funny part is that the user manual is much thinner than the owner's manual. So I guess that there is information in it that people, the user, doesn't supposed to know. I think this manual tells you about the 10 different ways this car is going to try to kill you. Mind me. But we are not normal people, so we're not going to use any manual. No, ma'am. Let's look what we have here. We got a steering wheel, we got a tooter, map, map, the klaxon, how do you call it? The manettino, aka the kill switch, and of course, we got the engine. Yes, yes, start button. And you know, the funny part is that I've been in a lot of cars, and often cars say start, and you have to push the start button to turn it off. In this case, you just use a key. Well, I thought it was funny. Huh. Okay, so what we got? Let's come in. Beep beep. Well, so I closed the door because I can show you more when the door is open. Closed, yes, well. What we have here, we got some lighting buttons. You have some adjustments for the steering wheel. Very handy. You got the display, and the display tells you things like the lap time, current lap. Oh man! Yeah. Tire information, temperature, etc. Very cold outside right now. The traveling distance of the trips. Yes, I understand. And the basic information that you will need in order to drive this baby. You got the instrument panel here. Lock and unlock the doors, I think. Changing to automatic. Reverse. LC, liquid cooled, I don't know. Opening the glove box, very handy. And the emergency lights, and then we have here the climate control. I'm not gonna tamper with it. And, oh, wait, push. A radio. Okay, do we need a radio in a Ferrari? No, ma'am, so I'll go and close that one. And keep it that way. So electric windows everywhere, and here are some more information, and I don't know what the heck I'm looking at. Tire pressure check, I guess, maybe something with, well, who cares. So let's adjust the seats and have a ride. Memory 1, 2, 3, that okay. See what happens. Whoa! Oh, that's the back. Yes. Oh. Oh man.
Want...
And even heated. Wow. Guys. I don't know if you saw how many buttons there were. I was like, oh my god, which one I'm gonna touch. But I just learned that you can adjust the seat in the width, in the depth, in the... This, no, every... So, question, is this car comfortable? Yes, it is. Can you drive Italy? Yes, you can. Can anybody do it? Yes. Thick, thin, small, long, doesn't matter. You can drive this baby. Amazing car. I love it. It feels a little bit wide, I have to admit. But we're taking this slow. Oh, did you hear that? Well, so I could go on blabbering about how big the brakes are, the bore and stroke, or that the fact that it has four valves, a cylinder or something. But to be honest, I told you this many times before in my video. If you want to know things like that, you just Google it, because Google knows way more than I do. But just enjoy this ride, it's more important. And I think this is a car that can take you to Amsterdam, from Amsterdam to Italy, without any problems. In fact, maybe, I don't think the owner will allow me to. Didn't even push the throttle because I'm afraid. And still, it feels like, I'm just upshifting just so you can hear me better, but it feels like there's so much power in this car. 620 horses are pushing me, pushing constantly. I think those 620 horses in this V12 engine here are there to kill you. Hear the sound of the... If I can compare this car with my 308, there's one thing I immediately feel that is quite the same, is the excitement, the noise, the... When I'm driving my car, it makes me feel like I am on top of the world, happy. Make the engine play a tune or something, like a great theater show. Now I know why everybody compares the sound of an engine to classical music, because it is. It's just classical music in your ears. Well, we know that the seats are comfortable. We know that the dash gives you all the information you need. We know it has a radio that you don't need, but imagine driving this car from Amsterdam to Italy and back. I think you can do that without any problems, but can you take enough luggage with you? Let's have a look. Well, I'm pretty surprised. Here's the cover. You can put that aside, but that I think that you can put two suitcases in it, some groceries, and even a tent, I think. And have a look. I said have a look. So you have the cover, and here we have some extra room for some stuff you don't want the customs to see. Always handy. And underneath, there's the toolkit. Well, so more than enough room. And the funniest part is, I will get you back to my face. The funny part is, you also got the shelves inside where you can also put at minimum 2 bags. So don't worry guys, you can take your wife with you. Let's go to Italy. Anyway, in my opinion, the Ferrari 599 is a very successful Ferrari. They made these cars from 2006 until 2012, I believe. The numbers, I don't know. Ferrari is very unopen. How do you call it in English? I don't know. But I think approximately 5,000 units were built. Some with manual transmission. And I can understand why people would love a manual transmission. But to be honest, I love the F1 style gearbox. I really, really love it. Simply listen to the sound. You are in control. And if the standard 599 wasn't good enough for you, you could also get the HGTE handling package. The HGTE handling package, yes. Better suspension, stiffer suspension, I believe. I have to get to know how to stop. That's a learning process. So you can use you can get the HGTE package for this car. I think that the styling that belongs to that package is just absolutely stunning. Oh my. So, in 2010, at the end of the life cycle of the 599, Ferrari introduced the 599 GTO, basically a street legal version of the 599. Well, I have to say it correctly, a street legal race version of the 599. The GTO is the Gran Turismo Omologato, I don't know. I forgot. I wrote it down before I started it, but I'm so excited I forget almost everything I wanted to talk about. But who cares? Simply because this experience is about driving, and this car is about driving. And well, it sure drives like I've never done it before. Fantastic. So after the GTO, Ferrari built the 599 SA Aperta, Sergio and Andrea Pininfarina. That car was to celebrate the 80th birthday of Pininfarina, the design house that designed this car. And only 80 units are built, but it's one of my favorite cars all time. It's just absolutely stunning. I hope one day, I've seen a few in real life, but I hope to someday be able to join someone who's driving a car like that. But that's all about dreams. Just beware of the traffic. Here in Holland, we don't have a lot of spaces where you can drive. So now I'm just looking for some free space. Oh man, this is scary. Wow. So Yeah. to 100 in 3.7 seconds. It will take you only 11 seconds to reach about 200 kilometers an hour. And if you are not afraid and you are ready to keep pushing the pedal, you will reach a speed about 330 kilometers an hour. That's three times the speed limit here in Holland. Explain to my kids when I got home why is daddy smiling so much. Cause I'm happy. Oh, did I just do that? Yes, I did. So easy playing around with the pedals, and we're not even going at high speeds or something. We're just cruising along. And I feel so I am aware that this car is constantly trying to kill you, but somehow it also gives me the feeling that I am safe, that I don't have to be afraid. I am, but I don't have to be. And if only I could get the shifting right, because I'm still learning this car. I got about between 2,000 and 8,000 RPM where you can shift depending on what are you doing. And it's just the playing field. What do you like? What do you feel? And when I look around me, I feel so blessed. This is a man-made machine, man. Come on. Thank you, Ferrari. Thank you for building this. So I forgot, because I told you just about the 599 GTO and the 599 SA Aperta. I have to say it correctly. But they also built a 599 XX, and later development was the 599 XX Evolution. And these cars are on a complete different level. Built truck purpose only. I believe that you didn't even get to take your car home when you bought it. But that combined with each other proves to me that this is a very successful Ferrari. And some people say V12 is for old guys. Mm-mm, it's not. It's just a fantastic car. Everybody can drive this. You have to treat it with respect, but everyone can drive this. I told you before that I'm not going to go into detail about all the technical features of this car. If you want to know more about that, just Google it, because Google knows more than I said it before. But I do want to show you this here. And I'll adjust the camera a little bit here. Yeah. This is the same 6-liter V12 engine as used in the Ferrari Enzo. 620 horsepower. And look how far this engine is tucked away in the car. It's almost a mid-engine car. Unbelievable. I wanted to get the okay, I admit I am quite stupid. Fun fact, did you know that this Ferrari is the first Ferrari with an iPod connection holder, like we care, just like having a radio. Ha ha ha! I love this. I really love this gearbox. Sorry, guys. Well, this day has been absolutely amazing. I want to thank my man Mike for giving me this opportunity to drive a car like this. It's just so much. Pleasure. That's what it gave me. Vitamin F, guys. You need vitamin F. So I want to thank Mike. Please visit his website, by the way. ChallengeStradale.com. Mike always also lost the Challenge Stradale. And he has a website dedicated to the to it. So make sure to visit it one day. And with that bombshell and with that knowledge, I would like to thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe. If you want to see me more and make more videos like this, let me know. And I want to thank you and a goodbye. Bye bye.